But no, what I really wanted to hit up for man-made movies, this is kind of an interesting question. I know there's going to be a lot of talk of time travel. You guys got a panel really going over that.
Yeah.
And I'm kind of curious, as filmmakers and game players, are we a little more ready for the idea of time travel? Do you think that, you know, the average person, is that where some of that comes from?
I don't know. I kind of feel like the sci-fi fans out there and the sort of the geeks out there have a much greater awareness of what the camps are between hard sci-fi and soft sci-fi. And for me, and I think for other geeks, time travel is one of those things that kind of sits in the gray area. And it's you can kind of understand the theoreticals of how it works. But, you know, with Moon, we talked about technologies where you could actually see the progression of how we could get from humanity and the technology we have today to where it would be in Moon. Mm-hmm. And with time travel, there's some leaps of faith there before you get to time travel. But I think what Ben Ripley did, who wrote the script, is he really kept it coherent, and he made it, you know, he made it understandable to the audience, both to science fiction fans and to people who are maybe not as into that kind of genre.
Right, because you know, it's funny, you get to thinking, even in a normal non-sci-fi film, you film out of order.
Yeah.
You know, and video games, it used to do more the old ones than the new ones. It's like, I'm gonna get to a point, I'm gonna save.
Yeah.
And then I'm gonna try thing A. Oh, that didn't work. I'm going to go back to my save spot and try thing B.
Absolutely.
And it really seems like source code kind of speaks to that.
Completely. Well, reading the script, that really came across to me. You know, the whole idea that it's sort of you have multiple opportunities to sort of perform the mission until you get it right. Mm-hmm. So when I was thinking about visuals and how to tell the story, I wanted to make a couple of little homages to the games industry. Mm-hmm. And there's a very obvious one, which, you know, when you see the film, when you see the film, you'll pick up on Jake jumps out of a train and there's just a straight lift from the Grand Theft Auto games, where the camera starts off over his shoulder, like the old-fashioned over-the-shoulder shot, which rotates right round him and stays with him as he jumps out the train and goes tumbling down the platform.
That's
so
awesome.
You know, there's little moments in there where I try and do things to tie those two worlds together, because as you know, games and films are things that are both equally of interest to me.
Yeah. And it seems like, man, you got to play with some fun toys this time around, man. I mean, obviously, you're not scraping for peanuts sort of budget anymore on this. This is the real deal, man.
It's a move up. You know, I'm working with the Hollywood guys this time. Don Burgess was my cinematographer, and he did Forrest Gump. So he's, you know, amazing cinematographer. He did The Book of Eli, which is an amazing looking film.
Uh-huh.
And then my editor was a guy called Paul Hirsch, who did Empire Strikes Back, Ferris Bueller's Day Off. He won an Oscar for Ray, did Mission Impossible. He's a legend and an absolute, like an institution in Hollywood. So the chance to have him sort of teach me for the amount of time we were editing was like going back to film school. It was fantastic.
Yeah, I mean, I can only imagine that there's just a wealth of information. I mean, do you just have like the big master checklist of, okay, these are all the people in Hollywood I'm gonna work with?
That's how the whole thing started. I mean, I was meeting with people that I hoped to work with in the future. I mean, you know, Mute, and I was trying to get Mute off the ground again. And I met up with Jake Gyllenhaal in order to see if he'd be interested. And he said, oh, yeah, in the future, that would be great. But right now, I've got this script, source code.
So Jake whipped you in.
Yeah, Jake was the one who sort of brought me in, and he sort of put source code in front of me, and I read it and I got excited about it. I thought there's some things here that I could really I could get my teeth into. So that's how it all started.
That is the process is so fascinating, I think, to people who don't do this for a living.
Yeah.
They're just like, oh, these movies get made, and you know, just that sort of train of ABC.
Yeah, I mean it's I've been in kind of a unique position in that Moon came together very fast. And then straight after Moon, I went to Source Code, and that's come together really, really fast. I know that, you know, sometimes people struggle for years and years, like with Mute, to get a film made. But fortunately, with these two films, you know, the approach and the way I wanted to do it just seemed to click with the people who were involved. So we were able to just get on it and get it made, and had a lot of fun doing it.
What are you looking for to get Mute done? Obviously, it's been one of those where you have it in the back pocket.
Stuart and I, over the last couple of days, have been discussing it a lot, because we already know what we're going to be doing next, and it's not going to be Mute. But we've decided that rather than just keep on kicking it down the street for the future, we're going to get a graphic novel made. So we're going to do Mute as a graphic novel, And you know, we started talking to various people. I don't know if so. I tweeted out sort of asking about who are good companies to talk to. Got an avalanche of emails. So it's been great. So we're literally as soon as South by Southwest over and source code is on its way and we've kind of launched it, then yeah, we'll get onto that and we'll start talking to some companies and find out who we can get the graphic novel done with.
That is so cool. can you mention what is next with you?
Not really. Okay. I mean, I'm in the middle of writing and you know, Summit's been really good and they're putting me up on, you know, like lovely flights so I can sit down, put my laptop out, plug it in and get some writing done as we fly from city to city. But that's you know, I'm very excited about it. And the good thing is that I'm very confident that it will be the next film and that we'll be able to get it made.
That is so cool. This is for your blog, obviously. This is for Neil and all the guys.
Yeah.
Is there anything you want to just tell straight pipe to your fans? No cuts, no edits.
Here they are. You know, I've been so lucky to have everyone, you know, interested in what it is that I'm trying to do and the people I'm working with are trying to do. And we'll keep on working and try not to let you down.
Awesome. Duncan.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us
here. Thank you so much.
Bolivar Lounge, Austin, Texas. Your premiere is like 2 blocks that way. We'll be seeing you on the red carpet.
Okay.
As Real News. But this is for you, your blog.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.